Jay Shrek.
James.
Myth, legends, and lies. What if I told you that there are millions of dollars worth of treasure that's not gold in the Superstition Mountains?
Not the Dutchman's gold. I don't know. What would you tell me it was?
I would say, what if I told you there were priceless paintings?
Oh, I've heard of this before. Yes.
Priceless paintings.
I don't know a whole lot about it. Well, I do know a little bit about it, but yes, I've heard there are.
So, if you know, one thing is a lot of people go up there. Now, one thing that's funny about this is that in this day and age, right, nobody really has been around since the Lost Dutchman was going through Superstition Mountains, right? You agree with that?
Yes.
I mean, nobody's alive just because of the years, right?
Yeah. Okay.
But there are people that are still alive when the next big treasure was supposedly put in the Superstition Mountains by Ted DeGrazia.
Yep. Right? Yep, in the 1970s.
There were people that were around that are still alive. So the Dutchman, we don't have that connection with that person directly. We have indirect connections, but we've kind of lost a little bit of the history in between that, right? I mean, because we don't know anybody that was there when Adolf Ruth got, you know, the guy got blown away, right?
Yes.
But we have people that have been around since DeGrazia took his paintings. And do you know the story?
I do.
What is it?
The basic story is that Ted DeGrazia was upset about taxing that was going to be put on some of his unsold paintings and stuff. So he was going to be leaving his wife when he was getting towards the end of his life and thinking about things of that nature. And so he got mad at the government, essentially the state and federal government, because they were going to tax these millions of dollars worth of paintings that he had. And so in protest, he got a reporter to go up with him to the mountains and the Superstitions.
So this is all verified, too. This isn't like a rumor or a myth.
This is verified stuff. Yes.
And there's pictures in the paper.
I was going to say there's photographic evidence of a bonfire of his paintings. He went into and he made a big statement by burning, like, what was supposedly millions of dollars worth of paintings, $1 million worth of paintings in the 1970s. Then after that, there is reports and, I believe the guy's name, Bob Ward, wrote a book, and it contained a map that him and DeGrazia put together of paintings he went up and hid in the mountains. There's two sides of it. There's one that he was putting it up there almost as like a treasure to be found, like the Dutchman. And then there's the other that it was for his wife to go find after the fact. Because once the attention was drawn that he was, like, not going to pay those taxes on the paintings, that they wanted that little stockpile for his wife after his death.
You know, he had a pretty interesting lifestyle, and I don't think that should affect this story at all. But then sometimes it could, right? Because what we've got to do is deduct, did he really? We know he burnt some paintings.
Yeah,
there's
pictures of it.
What kind of pictures of it? How many, we're not sure exactly.
Yeah, what the value was, I have not read any of that stuff.
But we do know that he did it.
Yes.
We know he was there. We know that he did burn some of these paintings in protest. The value of those paintings would be maybe up to him. And then he took two, supposedly, as this goes, the story goes, he took two tubes of paintings rolled up, non-framed, right?
Mm-hmm.
And hid them in the Superstition Mountains to either, like you say, his wife to come get them, or as a loss, I guess.
Yeah, as I read it, Bob Ward was given the map, and he was supposed to give that to his wife, and then somehow it ended up published in his book. Let's just throw that out there, that I did read this.
You know, is that back to the... You know, a lot of people have not got interested in the story we did on the Lost Dutchman Mafia.
Yeah.
And I think they're really missing the boat. I really do.
I think so.
And if you're a serious Dutch hunter, you need to understand what our philosophies behind that were. Because nothing happened in those Superstition Mountains with those guys not knowing.
Yeah.
And just like this here, DeGrazia gives this guy a map, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's supposed to give to his wife.
Yep.
And he publishes it.
Yeah.
I mean...
That's the story I've read on multiple people's accounts, is that because it was designated to be given to her and instead ended up published in his book.
Because I don't think you could trust a lot of the people that were floating around the Lost Dutchman or looking for the gold or any other thing up there. I don't think you could. But you know, the thing about DeGrazia that I find fascinating, though, is that this is another... This could be, value-wise, could be, I mean, God only knows, this could value equal the Lost Dutchman mine. I mean, depending on what it is and how it is, this act, and we know this is real. We know he was there. We don't know positively that those got hidden, right? But no, we know for sure that this went down.
Yeah.
Now, if it was another scam, we don't know that either. Now, those paintings are supposed to be by a old corral that is right by the ruins. Is that correct?
That is correct.
That's what Angel Falls, is that?
Yes, I think so.
And the story goes is that he took them out without a shovel. You know, so he took these paintings, these sealed paintings in these tubes, right? Mm-hmm. And he took them out, but he didn't have a shovel. So he came back in about 15 minutes. Is that what?
Something like that. In one of the accounts.
So, you know, what could you do? You could take a walk 15 minutes. You could take a perimeter. You could circle that perimeter in 15 minutes. Okay. And then that would be the outer perimeter. This is how I would do it.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd go out 15 minutes and then, and then walk. Well, if he came back within 15 minutes, that means he's only 7 minutes out, right?
Yes.
So that means that, you know, within 7 minutes, he found whatever. He didn't dig a hole, so he either had a hole already dug, or he put him somewhere where, you know, they were in a cave or something.
Hide him in some natural thing, right? Yeah, okay.
So it should be in that perimeter and should be able to find that if it didn't get burnt. Now, I know that some of that area burned up there, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, with the Woodbury Fire, yeah.
So, depending on how far it was, I know they saved the ruins, right?
Yep, that's what, yeah.
So, depending on how close they were to Angel Springs.
Yeah, if you take, like, what the accounts are and how the cliff dwellings were preserved, it's just because they were just high enough up on the rock that it went under. So, if these things were stashed somewhere above what basically was the fire line, they would still be around.
Mm-hmm.
If it turns out that he had buried them, they'd probably still be buried.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else, you know, who knows? So you might find burned remnants or something of that nature.
You know, we tried to contact the museum or the you know, the down in Tucson.
Oh, DeGrazia's.
Because I wanted to work some deals up with them, and they no response back. They didn't want anything to do with the, I guess the Lost Dutchman part of their story is not something that they... want to delve into forward or backwards, and just let the sleeping dog lie, right, as they say. They didn't want to get into that, and you know, who knows, maybe they know something, maybe they know more than we know, you know, maybe they went and got him. Who knows, at one time maybe somebody actually went and got him after this story, because you know, the other thing is that he could have so let's look at it. He was a different cat. I'm not saying that meant he was not honest, but he was a different cat. I'll just leave it at that. And so he could have said he burned a lot more paintings than he did.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean,
yeah.
He could have not left any paintings up there. Now, that's not like what the story says. But, you know, if he stuck them up there, he still would have owned them. So it wasn't like he would have been able to not write them off or, you know, He could have stuck them anywhere, right? So he had to either... Now, one thing about him that was fascinating was, man, he painted a lot of paintings.
He was really prolific.
He really painted a ton of paintings. Yeah. It wasn't like he just had a couple. I mean, he painted thousands and thousands and thousands
of paintings.
You know, so he had a lot of paintings. So it'd be hard to say where this one or that one went when they were cataloging or whatever, right? And, you know, but it's a fascinating story. It truly is. And so... when we can get back in, that was on the listing, you know, that was on the listing. We did a little bit of a loop when we were down there to kind of look at some of the areas. You know, the corral is missing, it's gone.
Yeah.
You can see a few rocks still that you think is still the same one. So you can still get somewhat of a bearing down there. We're going back up to go find those. Along with making a loop into where Adolph Roos said that the Lost Dutchman was. Mm-hmm. It's really pretty fascinating that we have at least two different things that we can find that could possibly be have some value. And one, you know, no one really knows about the Lost Dutchman gold, but we know those paintings, that event took place.
Yeah.
Now, whether he put them in there or he didn't put them in there, who really knows? But if you were a true treasure hunter, I would go with the paintings because we have factual information of the events that took place. Now, again, we can't verify all that information. We don't know for sure, absolutely, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that those paintings got put in there. But would it be worth the journey? Absolutely, it would be worth the journey.
I'm actually sometimes more fascinated by the DeGrazia story than I am even the Dutchman gold, because there's a lot more speculation in it, and this story is like recent, more modern history, so it's like, oh, that's really fascinating. Plus, he's really cool, man. He was a huge influence in the popularity of the Superstitions. His art really is prolific, and, you know, he did some really cool imagery of the mountains, and brought a lot of attention to it. I mean, I think he's a huge part of the people who come for, like, the ecotourism element of the mountains, and that's really cool.
You know, one of the things that you bring up, a good point you bring up, James, is that people don't realize that he was fascinated with the Lost Dutchman as well.
Yeah, exactly.
And so if it wasn't for that fascination he had as a youth, when he used to spend time in the Superstition Mountains and fell in love with it, mm-hmm. I mean, he loved the Superstition Mountains. That's the reason he went back there. When he made his stand up there, he went to the Superstition Mountains. Yeah. They packed him in. You know, he did the deal. Packed him in by mule. And so because of his love for the Superstitions is why he performed that. And if it wouldn't have been for that, then he would have never probably been there, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So, you know, the legend of the Superstition Mountains definitely did bring him in there. To him to be part of that legend, mm-hmm. you know, and maybe that was part of what he wanted to do too, is become become part of the legend of the Superstition Mountains.
Well, I mean, that's actually what's really neat about that whole region in general as well, is because so many people are like, I want to be a part of this, and like, mm-hmm. you know, we've been following Waltz and his legacy for so long. I want to be part of that too, and you know, then you got someone like DeGrazia, who's like got that artistic, outside the box mindset, and he's like, I'm gonna do it, like, here, I'm gonna do this, and so it just gives guys like me and you one more thing to kind of delve into, and like we always say, if nothing else, it's an amazing excuse to be out there.
Why wouldn't they be there, though? They should.
That's
be.
I mean, they I believe be. They would still be
why
there.
Why would they? Because he could paint. I mean, again, he wasn't like this master painter that only produced 15 or 20 paintings, right? He produced thousands upon thousands of paintings. The guy was just—he was a machine, right?
From what I understand, like a lot, he was always doing work. He did pottery, all kinds of things.
So if he had 40 or 50 paintings in these tubes, 60 paintings, 100, even 100 paintings. Let's say 200 paintings. I mean, that wouldn't even have put a dent in his creative endeavor, because he, you know, it wouldn't have been that big a deal to him. So could there be 100 original paintings up there? Let's just say 100. Could there be 100 paintings up there in the Superstition Mountains? Hell yes, there could. And I think we should go get them.
I'm absolutely game for going and looking. We started a little bit, and then we're kind of held up by the fire and stuff. So mm-hmm. I'd like to get back out there and keep looking.
So, man, I'm excited about that story. I really am, because I'm telling you what. That's true. That's true treasure. True treasure.
No, that's exactly right. Like, just to be the guys who kind of, just to even have the opportunity to go look for them. But if you were to be someone who found it and like brought that artwork mm-hmm. out and were like, hey, look what, you know, that's kind of neat. That'd be a really cool part of history to be involved in.
Now, on this podcast, I'm going to put a couple pictures as we're going to do this, so you can see that there are documented pictures of him there actually burning mm-hmm. some of the paintings, right?
Yeah.
And then, man, I tell you what, that's exciting. I tell you, this fire has jacked us all up, hasn't it?
It really did put like a huge twist in what we're trying to do. Right. I mean, we were doing the Apache Loop, we were doing this stuff, and like got put right in the middle of it. So we had to go find some other more interesting stuff to occupy our time until we could get back out there and look for the paintings and keep looking for the gold.
Right. Jay Shrek.
And James.
on the trail of the DeGrazia paintings.